Good morning, children. Happy to see you all once again in this online class. Hope you all enjoyed your holidays and doing good. Just thank and praise God for all the blessings He showered on us. Begin every day with a grateful heart. Be thankful for the blessings of the little things. Every day is a gift from God. So just say, I'm thankful for today. Before we move into today's learning, let's do a small recap now. In the previous class, we studied about Newton's laws. Okay, we first studied about the relation between the force and the motion by Aristotle and Galileo. And then we studied about Newton's first law, then types of inertia, inertial frames. Then we studied about Newton's second law. What is Newton's second law? Force acting on an object is equal to the rate of change of momentum. And then we studied about Newton's third law. And finally, we discussed about the Newton's laws. Today, let's learn about the applications of Newton's laws. Let's see what is a free body diagram. It's a simple tool to analyze the motion of the object using Newton's laws. Now, let's see the steps involved in it. First one, identifying the forces acting on an object, then representing the object as the point mass, and finally drawing the vectors representing the forces acting on the object. Now, while drawing the free body diagram, the forces exerted should not be included. Now, let's see one example. That is a mango falling from a tree. What are the forces acting on the mango? They are the gravitational force exerted by the earth on the mango acting downwards along the negative y-axis. The other force is the tension, which acts upward along the positive y-axis. That is due to the cord attached to the mango. Okay, now if you see the free body diagram, now the mango acts as the point mass and the gravitational force acting downwards and the tension acting upwards. Now, let us learn about the particle moving in an inclined plane. So, what do you mean by inclined plane? That is a slanting plane. So, let us consider the object of mass m moving on a frictionless inclined surface. So, the inclined plane is kept at an angle theta. By knowing the force acting on the particle, we can find out the acceleration of the object and the speed of the object when it reaches the bottom. Now, let's see the forces acting on the object. The two forces acting on the object, one is the downward force, which is the gravitational force, which is denoted by mg, and the other force is the normal force, which is acting perpendicular to the inclined surface. Now, see in this picture, mb the mass of the object moving on an inclined plane, and ab the acceleration acting along this direction, and S be the distance and H be the height. Now we have to draw the gravitational force in this direction and normal force in this direction perpendicular to the inclined plane. So we can consider the block to be the point mass. So this be the free body diagram. Next we have to choose the coordinate system. So with respect to the inclined plane. So the gravitational force mg is resolved into two components, the parallel component mg sin theta along the inclined plane and the perpendicular component mg cos theta, which is perpendicular to the inclined surface. The angle made by the gravitational force mg with the perpendicular to the surface is equal to the angle of inclination theta. Now let's see the explanation how we got theta. When I extend this line, I will get a right angle triangle. Now, this angle be 90 degree. Now, let us consider this angle to be theta 1. So, the total angle will be what? 90 degree plus theta 1, which is equal to 180 degree. So, theta 1 will be equal to 180 degree minus 90 degree minus theta. So, it becomes theta 1 is equal to 90 degree minus theta. But from the figure, we know that theta 2 plus theta 1 is equal to 90 degree. So that is, this angle is 90 degree. So theta 2 is, we can from this, we can say that theta 2 is equal to 90 degree minus theta 1. Now substituting theta 1 in equation theta 2. So we will get theta 2 is equal to 90 degree minus 90 degree plus theta. So the value will become theta 2 will be equal to theta. So now we know how we got this theta. Now there is no motion along the y-axis. That is, there is no acceleration along the y-axis, since the motion of the object is only along the x-axis. Now applying the second law in y-direction. So when we apply the second law in y-direction, what will happen? We know that force is equal to mass into acceleration. Since acceleration is equal to zero, F will be equal to zero. So already we know we studied about the three steps to draw the free body diagram. So the third step we have to write in vector form. The forces acting along y-axis be normal force, and the other force is in the opposite direction. So we have to write negative sign. So minus mg cos theta j cap plus n j cap, because nj is in the positive direction, which is equal to zero because acceleration is zero. Okay, so we can, if you take j as common, you can write j cap bracket n minus mg cos theta, which is equal to zero. Now by comparing the components, j has no component, so it becomes n is equal to mg cos theta. The object slides along the x direction, so it has a acceleration, so it moves along with the acceleration. So now applying the Newton's second law in the x direction, now force acting along the x direction be mg sin theta I cap, which is equal to ma I cap, because ma is nothing but force according to Newton's second law. So now by comparing the components, it becomes mg sin theta is equal to ma, where m and m get cancelled, so a is equal to g sin theta. So we got the acceleration of the sliding object be g sin theta. So first we found out what is the acceleration, now we have to find out the speed. So we know a is equal to g sin theta. Now acceleration depends upon theta, so theta is 90 degree, so sin 90 degree becomes 1. So acceleration a is equal to g. Now Newton's kinematic equation is used to find out the speed of the object when it reaches the bottom. So we can use one of the kinematic equation, which is v square is equal to u square plus 2as. Okay, that is along the x direction. So we know a is equal to g sin theta. When I'm substituting the values, u is equal to 0 because the initial velocity is always taken as 0. So v square is equal to u square becomes 0, so 2g sin theta into s. So v is equal to root of 2gs sin theta. From this we can find out the speed of the object. Now let's see the next application. Okay, now let us find out the forces acting on two bodies in contact on a horizontal surface. Now consider two blocks of masses m1 and m2, where m1 is greater than m2. Both are kept in contact with each other on a smooth, horizontal, frictionless surface. Now by applying horizontal force F, both the blocks are set into motion with acceleration A in the direction of force F. In order to find acceleration, I am using Newton's second law. Since the two blocks are moving together, instead of taking it as M1 and M2, we can take it as combined mass, like M is equal to M1 plus M2. So according to Newton's second law, force is equal to mass into acceleration. Since the motion of two masses are along the positive x direction, we can write Fi cap is equal to Ma I cap, that is in vector notation. Now by comparing, it becomes F is equal to M into A. Now we know the total mass M is equal to M1 plus M2. So F is equal to M1 plus M2 into A. So we can find out from this, we can find out the acceleration. So acceleration is equal to F by M1 plus M2. The block M1 exert force on M2 and M2 exert force on M1. So which we call it as the force of contact. Now according to Newton's third law, block M2 will exert equal and opposite reactional force, that is F12 on M1. Now from the free body diagram, we can say that FB the greater force acting in the positive x direction and F12 be the force by the block M2 which is acting along the negative x direction. So we can write it as Fi cap minus F12i cap, that is because it is in the negative direction, which is equal to M1ai cap, because M1a represents the force according to Newton's second law. Now comparing the components, we can write as F minus F12 is equal to M1a, or we can write F12 is equal to F minus M1a. Now substituting the value of acceleration, we already know a is equal to F by M1 plus M2. So F12 is equal to F minus M1 into F by M1 plus M2. Now taking F outside, if we take F outside, it becomes F12 is equal to F into inside the bracket 1 minus M1 by M1 plus M2. Okay, now it becomes F12 is equal to F into M2 by M1 plus M2. Now the magnitude of contact of force depends on M2, which provides the reaction force. The force is acting along the negative x direction. So the reaction force, that is the mass, is given by F12 is equal to M2 by M1 plus M2. So for mass M2, there is only one force acting along the x direction. So it is denoted by F21. So first we considered the mass M1. Now we have to consider the mass M2, where only one force is acting on it, which is along the x direction. Now according to the free body diagram, F21 be the force acting on mass M2. Okay, now applying Newton's second law for mass M2, it becomes F2i, which is equal to, because that is the only force acting, so F2i cap is equal to M2ai cap. Now by comparing the components on both sides of the above equation, it becomes F21 is equal to M2a. So now substituting for acceleration, we know acceleration is equal to F by M1 plus M2. So we get F21 is equal to FM2 by M1 plus M2. So here it shows the direction of forces along the positive x direction. So in vector notation, the force acting on the mass M2 exerted by the mass M1 is given by F21 is equal to F of M2 by M1 plus M2. So by comparing these two, that is F12 is equal to minus of F21, now which confirms the Newton's third law. So Newton's third law is verified. Now let's see the third application, that is the motion of connected bodies. When objects are connected by strings and a force is applied either vertically or horizontally and it produces tension in the string and also the acceleration is affected. So let's see the first case, the vertical motion. Now consider two blocks of masses M1 and M2 and they are connected by a string where M1 is slightly greater than M2. Let the tension in the string be T and the acceleration be A. When the system is released, both this block starts moving and M2 moves vertically upwards and M1 moves vertically downwards. The upward direction is shown as the y direction. The free body diagram is shown here for both the masses M1 and M2. Now applying Newton's second law for mass M2. So when you apply, what are the forces acting on it? One is the tension, the other one is due to the gravitational force. So it can be written as T j cap minus M2 g j cap is equal to M2 a j cap. Now the left hand side here, it shows the force acting on the block and the right hand side is nothing but mass into acceleration according to Newton's second law. Now comparing both sides, we will get T minus M2 g is equal to M2 a. And similarly for mass M1, which will be T j cap minus M1 g j cap is equal to minus M1 a j cap. Because here M1 moves in downward direction, so minus j cap. Okay, now on comparing, we will get T minus M1 g is equal to minus M1 a, or M1 g minus T is equal to M1 a. Now by adding the two equations, that is T minus M2 g is equal to M2 a and M1G minus T is equal to M1A. So by adding those two equations, we will get M1G minus M2G is equal to M1A plus M2A. M1 minus M2G is equal to M1 plus M2 into A. Or we can write A is equal to M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 into G. If both the masses are equal, that is M1 is equal to M2, then A will be equal to 0. Now, in order to find the tension in the string, now substitute the value of acceleration in that equation. So, I'm substituting acceleration in equation T minus M2G is equal to M2A. So, if I substitute that value, I will get T is equal to M2G plus M2 into M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 into G. Now, taking M2G outside, we will get M2G inside the bracket, which will be 1 plus M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2. Now, by multiplying, you will finally get T is equal to 2M1 M2 by M1 plus M2 into G. Now, writing the acceleration for in vector form for M1 will be vector A is equal to minus M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 into J cap. And acceleration in vector form for M2 will be A vector is equal to M1 minus M2 by M1 plus M2 into J cap. Next, let us see the case 2, that is the horizontal motion. In this case, the mass M2 is placed on the horizontal surface and M1 is hanging with the help of a small pulley. Let us assume there is no friction acting on the surface. Now, both the blocks are connected with the help of an unstretchable string and M1 moves with an acceleration downward and M2 also moves with the same acceleration horizontally. Now, let's see the forces acting on M2. One is a gravitational force, that is M2G, then upward normal force N and horizontal tension T. And force acting on M1 will be gravitational force M1G and tension T, which is acting upward. Now, let's see the free body diagram for both the masses. Now, applying Newton's law for mass M1, which will be T J cap minus M1 G J cap is equal to minus M1 A J cap, which is along the y direction. Now, comparing both sides, we will get T minus M1 G is equal to minus M1 A. Now, applying Newton's law, second law for mass M2, that is along only x direction. There is no movement in the y direction. So, it will become T I cap is equal to M2 A cap. Now, by comparing both sides, we get T is equal to M2 into A. No acceleration along y direction. So, it becomes N J cap minus M2 G J cap is equal to 0. Therefore, on comparing, we get N minus M2 G is equal to 0 or N is equal to M2 into G. Now, by adding the two equations, that is T is equal to M2 A, that is due to the block M1. And T minus M1 G is equal to minus M1 A. So, by adding those two equations, we will get M2 A minus M1 G is equal to minus M1 A. Or we can write M2 A plus M1 A is equal to M1 G. Or A is equal to M1 by M1 plus M2 into G. Now, by substituting in the equation T is equal to M2 into A, we will get T is equal to M1 M2 by M1 plus M2 into G. Now, by comparing the two cases, the tension in the string for horizontal motion is half of the tension for vertical motion for same set of masses and strings. So, now let's see one application under this, that is the conveyor belts which moves in the horizontal motion, which work for longer duration than those of cranes and lifts which work in the vertical motion. So, in today's class, we saw the different applications of Newton's laws. Please watch the supplementary video and complete the test and play the quizzes. See you in the next class. Thank you.